Hi everybody, this will be a fun episode about African albums. I think many of you have seen that I have started collecting African albums, I think for 2 years now, 24 months, and I've come across some, I'm tempted to say amazing albums, but it's just on the other end of the spectrum. It are the bad, the ugly and the trashed albums. But they are rare, so I buy them anyway. I have an explanation and I wanted to share that because it's so funny. It's a really very nice explanation why are the records looking like they're doing. This album, for example, as you can already see, pieces are missing. It is blue. Usually there's big writing on them. If you look to the back, even bigger part is missing. This is not because of moisture or something. I think somebody has been, or something has been eating away on this record. But sometimes it's amazing when you clean these records, you can still make them sound good, and that is in part amazing. Even if you look on the label, you will see the same thing. Big writing on them, but on the other hand, cool label, very nice label. So that is what I wanted to show this time. So if you take, for example, this album, here actually the cover looks almost mint for African terms. Okay, there's a seam split, I mean, you can't have everything, but it looks pretty, pretty nice. And then it can be exactly the opposite. Record is completely, well, it even looks very nice after cleaning, but when I play it, you can hear it. Okay, there's a loop immediately at the start. And it is. It jumps. It crackles. There's background noise. And this is. I've tried everything I know to get this one in better shape, but I just can't do it. That's the gamble you sometimes take with these albums. But looking at the cover, I had a really, really high hope, because this is for me one of the grails of African records. It's an amazing album, but I have to look further, and I'm sure I will come across one in a better condition, but it shows what you can find. And the next one is also, this is, I mean, I think it has sometime during his life has been split, maybe partly lost, and as you can see, some nice small animal has eaten. I hope it was a small animal. But this one is also completely gone. The record, and this is also something you see again, typical writing everywhere. But the founders, I mean, again, a rare album. But this is also, so this one is actually missing a part. And as I found out, that's actually a good thing. Well, a good thing. The good thing is probably somebody played the music or the record for that reason, not so often. So if you play this one, it sounds pretty, pretty nice. So it's very difficult. Don't trust the cover. Don't trust a piece missing from the album. And of course you're thinking, why is this happening? How is it possible that there are gaps, cracked, gone? And usually you want to blame the previous owner. Didn't he take care? Didn't he know what he had in his hand? It's already amazing. These albums are more than 40 years old. They survived. So final, although it is very delicate material, it can withstand a lot of heat, sand. I don't know what it has been struggled to get over to my place, but I think it has seen a lot of the world. And I did, most of these albums I get from a guy who really travels to Nigeria with his girlfriend and picks up there the records. And he shared with me a clip that I want to share with you, because it explains why these records look like they look. I will play it now for you.
Bonjour, pastor. Yeah. No. Yeah. Yo. All of you that do good. Yeah. You know.
It's great to see those kids playing records. They're playing their records in a different way that we would do. But anyway, they clearly had a blast kung fu fighting with the vinyl. The next two that I want to show are not so much that they are damaged, as a lot is now explained why they are damaged, the covers and the records. But on some records, when you put them in Discogs, you have to look up the pressing, the release. Sometimes you have to fiddle around in the dead wax to see what pressing you have or what pressing plant. You need the magnifying glass. But in Nigeria, they solve that very easily. They just put it very big in the dead wax. I don't know really how they did it. It looks like they used some kind of needle to do this. Did it very carefully? No, it just goes through the run-out groove. When the needle comes close to the end, you have to pick it up, and because if you don't, the needle will just jump onto the next one. I will play it shortly. It's actually a nice album. And the fun thing is, when you look it up then on Discogs and you look up this release, the fun thing is there are loads of them. And the good thing is they have been imported to the US. I think they have some old stock there. So if you want a good copy, don't go to Nigeria for them. There's old stock in the US which you can buy from. Next album is a record which really, it puzzles me. Sometimes you have first pressing, and that's usually a promo copy. But when you get a promo copy, that's perfect. You cannot get any better. Nigeria, they don't do with stamp or something. If it is a promo copy, they just put on the top, not for sale. Please, explain, Mark. I mean, brilliant. I think the explanation is in part on the back. The label, I think it is their first release, LPAX001. This one is actually a very nice copy. As you can see, it is signed by Koffi Sabi. And if you want to know if it is really an original signature, it says so. It's by himself. Brilliant. There's more going on with this record, because it's very thick, and if you can see, you can still see the staples going through the cover. And I think they used another cover to put it together or something. So it was really, really their first album they did. And there's even an inner sleeve, which is again signed. I think it's number 60. I don't know. I think I have gold in my hands. A first pressing of Koffi Sabi. I mean, who has this kind of pressing? I mean, this must be unique. Too bad nobody wants it. That's a different story. These are the things I wanted to share with you, because when collecting African records, you come across the strangest things. And it was fun sharing it with you. Hope you enjoyed it also. See you in the next video.